in every good plant have what they call a tap root. And the tap root is where all the nurturing and the nutrition come in from the soil. In other words, the tap root has got a way of tapping into the soil and drawing up nitrogen and drawing up oxygen into that plant to nourish it. You and I got to be able that when we get into a situation, when we get into a circumstance, we got to have a living solution.
Amen.
Be able to reach down into the Word of God and say, I know the Lord can draw me out of this.
Amen.
He says, but others fail unto good ground. Everybody say good ground.
Good ground.
Now let me back up verse 7. I missed something. Some fell among thorns. Everybody say, oh my God. The thorns sprung up. Well, that's what thorns do. They spring up.
Yeah.
And then they choke the word. They choke what you're trying to listen to. They choke what you're trying to do. You got to be careful of them thorns.
Amen.
You got to be careful of them vines. And you see, one thing I learned about vines, they don't have no respect for nothing. You know what I'm talking about? When I was a kid down in North Carolina, I had a hustle. I ain't talking about a hustle like the kids talking today. I'm talking about a good hustle. Come on, somebody. I picked blackberries. That was my hustle. I picked plums. That was my hustle. Come on, somebody. I ain't the only one now. I sold papers. I did some legitimate. But that was what we call a true hustle.
Amen.
Today, I don't know what they call it today. It might be still hustle, but it got a different twist on it. But I'm talking about, I used to go blackberry picking, and early in the morning I'd get one of my mama's big pans, and I'd go down into the woods, and I would take me an old pasteboard box. Come on, somebody. And I'd go and put on my brogan. I'm going blackberry picking now. Somebody talk to me. You got to be equipped if you're going to fight the brides. Come on, somebody. Now we'll get down, and long before iPod and iPhone came out, and whenever Verizon came out with iPhone, a BlackBerry, I was picking BlackBerry. And my communication was being able to get that BlackBerry off the vine into your bucket. And I want you to understand, that BlackBerry vine had the smallest bricks that you can possibly imagine. And it would get all into your fingers and everything. You had to be able to pick that berry, get it from the vine, and not get stuck.
That's true.
You had to look out for spiders, and Lord knows, look out for black snakes.
That's true. Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
So what I would do, I would take my big old 11-foot and brogan, and I would go right up on the tree. From my baseboard box. Lay up against the bride, and I would just be dropping my blackberries and I come on, somebody. I always had some money. Somebody look somebody and say, he had some money.
He had some money. He had some money. Yes, he did.
He sold 32 cents for a quarter. I know it wasn't big money today, but it was big money then.
Yes, yes.
I picked them blackberries and I learned that the blackberry vine, it would grow and choke the trees. It would choke the fence, the wooden fence. It would choke anything that was in its pathway.
Amen.
And I got to thinking, you know, that vine is a tough thing.
Yes.
It didn't have no respect. It would crawl through the fence onto the other side. Whatever was in its way, it would just choke it.
Yep.
Yes, I know there ain't too many farmers in here, but
yep.
That's why you when you grow watermelons, you can't grow nothing else but watermelons. A watermelon will suck up all the nutrients, take up all the land, grow everywhere. And the root is so strong and so tight. Come on, somebody. Now, I love watermelon, but it's a selfish fruit. Come on, somebody. It sucks up all the nutrients. I know what I'm talking about. I've been around for a while. So you see, it's understanding to know that when the word is sown, you got to be careful of these thorns that grow up. Some folks sow thorns in their life and they can't get the word out because the thorn is choking the word.
That's it.
The thorn spring up and it chokes. You've seen folks get choked before.
Yep.
Some we all been choked before. Come on, somebody. Jesus said some of y'all got choked. See, y'all don't understand what I'm talking about. Let me hit you with this. He said they can swallow a camel, but they'll choke out a gnat. All right. You think I know what I'm talking about? See, yeah? Oh yeah, that's right. He did say that. I know what I'm talking about. And then in verse 8, he says, but others fell unto good ground. Everybody say good ground.
Good ground.
And brought forth fruit. It's important that when you carry the word of God, you have to be able to bring forth fruit.
That's it. Amen.
And your fruit, there's power in your tongue.
Amen.
Words that is life and death.
Right.
In the power of the tongue.
Right.
You can heal somebody or you can kill somebody.
Right.
With the word that you speak.
Right.
But don't think you can say anything and do anything and sow anything and expect to reap good things.
That's it. Preach on that.
Y'all get quiet, but I'm going to teach people in. You see, this lesson is about effects on preaching the gospel. That's what this parable is all about, preaching the gospel truth. You see, when we preach the truth with fruit, in some cases we're going to bring forth 100-fold.
Amen.
Some will bring 60-fold, and other times we'll bring 30-fold.
That's right.
That's why some folks sometimes they receive what you say,
uh-huh.
And sometimes half the time they might not receive everything you say.
Amen.
As long as you're sowing fruit. I'm here to tell you, God knows how to bless you with a bumper crop.
Yes, he does.
Look at somebody and say, God knows how to bless you.
God knows how to bless you.
With a bumper crop.
With a bumper crop.
Tell me y'all understand what a bumper crop is. Okay, let me put it into everyday language and then I'm going to break it down for you. A bumper crop means that if a farmer owned land or property and he planted corn, right, for some strange reason that the farmer can't explain, didn't understand that instead of having 7 ears to a stalk, he go out and when he begins to look on his stalk, he's got 14.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, maybe you don't understand what I'm trying to say here. It's just like when you go to your job and God give you a bonus paycheck. You don't call it a bumper crop, you call it a bonus.
That's right. Hey.
Ain't that right?
Hey.
You get one check and say, since you've been a good employee, since you came to work and did your job, since you went to lunch and came back on time, and you did what your supervisor said to you.
Amen.
I got a bonus check waiting for you.
Lord.
Someone going to get that bonus check and they ain't even got to work on time.
That's it.
I'm talking to your people this morning.
That's it.
I want you to understand that to every situation that you're going through, there is a solution. And it's a living solution that you can make a change in your life if you're willing to open up and receive the change. But I want you to understand there's a law in the making here, and this law is called the law of reciprocity.
Right. Amen.
You want things to happen your way? Do it the way it should be done.
Amen. True, true.
Amen.
Did the Bible teach us the golden rule?
Yeah.
Whatsoever you want man to do unto you, oh, somebody. Y'all ain't heard the golden rule. That's what we need to apply all the time. You see, God is going to multiply what you have. Man didn't give you this wealth. It is God that gives you your health and your wealth. It is God that gives you what you have. And all you do is stay open to the Lord, and he's got a solution to every problem that you're going through. And it's healing what you need. Go into the Word and say, Lord, according to your Word, you have a living solution. By your stripes, I am healed.
Amen. Amen.
God came back off his promise.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. We can back off our promise. Come on, somebody. We can say, I promise I'm going to do this, I promise I'm going to do that, and something can come up.
That's true.
Because you can't hold no promise. That's why you say, if the Lord's will, we'll do this and we'll do that.
That's true.
That lesson.